4 weeks ago, the dominant and bloodthirsty Culmination, Gory, Remy LeVay, and the Coker brothers entered eight-man tag team war against Crimson, his Disciples of the Dead, Alex Jordan and Sean Phoenix, and the Weapon of Mass Destruction, Abyss. The transformation of Phoenix and Jordan was evident early as an explosive fight erupted throughout Turner's Hall. The Culmination remained defiant and rebellious as ever, weathering the storm before finding an opening to pounce on their opposition like a pack of rabid animals. When Crimson finally had a chance to get his hands on Gory and avenge his betrayal, the New Age Plague ran from the scene, only to return to retrieve an equalizer. The same club the Culmination had bludgeoned Alex Jordan with a month ago. However, Abyss had an equalizer of his own. His girl Janice neutralized the Culmination's threat, allowing Crimson to score a pinfall and measure of revenge. But as the team celebrated, it was evident Crimson still had the desire to end Gory once and for all. A week later, the saga continued at a road event in Sandusky as they scheduled Atticus Coker and Remy LeVay versus Sean Phoenix and Alex Jordan match was marred by a savage pre-match attack that left Phoenix with an injured back and unable to compete. Alex Jordan tried his best to fight the odds, but soon the numbers game would catch up to him, allowing a two-on-one Culmination assault that led to the breaking of Alex Jordan's finger. A courageous Phoenix struggled to return to ringside against the wishes of premier officials and entered himself into battle. But where the heart was willing, the body on this day was not, and the Culmination gained an emphatic victory. What'll happen this Saturday night at Powder Keg? If the Coker brothers are victorious, Crimson leaves Premier forever. But if Jordan and Phoenix get the win, it's Crimson and Gory one-on-one this August at Anniversary.